This is our inner solar system. It consists of Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars, all of which travel around our Sun. Here you will also find the main asteroid belt that covers a large, diffusely populated region of our solar system, roughly between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. It is here, in the main belt, where we find Themis, a 200 to 250 kilometer wide asteroid, which is about the distance from the northern border of Tennessee to its southern border. With the help of NASA's infrared telescope facility, UTK's Josh Emery found evidence for the first time of water ice on the surface of an asteroid, as well as evidence of organic material.
So we've been monitoring asteroids in the main asteroid belt for a number of years, looking for specifically signatures of organic material and not finding it. It's uncertain how widespread organics are in the solar system. And the discovery of ice was just completely unexpected. And so finding ice at the position in the solar system that we found it and finding organic materials were both big discoveries in asteroid science.
Emery's research data tells us that Themis's exterior has a thin coating of ice, which is surprising since its surface should be too warm for ice to remain for a significant length of time. The researchers theorize that the asteroid's interior must have a rich and uniform reservoir of water ice that slowly migrates to the surface and replenishes the ice on the exterior.
The original nebula out of which the solar system formed, as it was forming, had a lot of hydrogen and had a lot of oxygen, and so almost certainly had a lot of water. The material from which the Earth formed was all close to the Sun. The Earth is pretty close to the Sun. And that material would have formed dry. But of course, we have all this water on the Earth. We couldn't live without all this water. So where did that water come from? Well, now we're seeing that asteroids were probably very water-rich. So it could have been perhaps the dominant carrier of water onto the Earth.
For Emery, space is more than the dark void that envelops our lonely planet. For him, space is a vibrant place of discovery and exploration, holding mysteries waiting to be explained.
When I go to the telescope and I point it at Themis and I collect data, no one else has seen that data before. You know, there was a time where I was the only one in the world who knew that there was water ice on Themis, and that's a really cool feeling. Exploration, I think, is thrilling to me. Growth of thought that it produces, I think humankind just needs. I mean, it's like, you know, well, why study art? Because art makes us think in new ways. It expands our horizons in ways we didn't plan. And exploration, the study of space, the study of new things, does that as well.
One giant leap for mankind.